Welcome to Ghamasan.com studio. Today we have a special guest with us, Mr. Gerard from Amsterdam, the Netherlands, who is working for women empowerment for many years. Mr. Gerard, what are you doing in women empowerment?
So I came 6 months ago to India and, to work on women empowerment. And I do that from a background of international development. So basically I'm from the healthcare sector. I did a few missions for the International Red Cross in the Foreign Affairs of the Netherlands, in Cameroon and Afghanistan. And right now, as a social entrepreneur, I'm coming to India to work on women empowerment, which means that I believe that after Me Too, it is time for Not Me, as I call it. And in Hindi, it seems to be said like Main Nahi. And so it's awareness on the fact that there are innovations and ways to stop it and to go for prevention. Not only awareness on the existence and that people need to heal from their wounds, but also we have to go for prevention with the use of technology. So that is where I want to go on the women empowerment field in India. Yes.
What technology you are using and what device you are using for women empowerment and safety?
Well, luckily I'm wearing it today, but this is the device.
Right.
It's a device that creates a network of guardians, which means that the device is connected to the application. The application, which is in the smartphone, does all the work. And within the application, you can create a network of guardians from your own phone book in the first place. And in the second place, as a volunteer, you can also register to be a guardian for people you don't know, which means that within 5 kilometers, if somebody presses the alarm, as a volunteer, you will be informed and you will see direct the location. You have an audio connection with the incident, and you can also alarm the police directly. So these are the three main features of the application. So the moment you get an alarm, you can take action and directly intervene on the spot. And you can alarm the police as well.
Yes.
So everybody is informed at the same time through the technology on the location, and they can hear the incident, and they can chat with each other and coordinate the activities they're going to take to rescue the person. So it's family and friends, volunteers within 5 kilometers, and the police. That's what that.
Yeah, as you already described about the function of this device, how much is the cost, and your company already started marketing in India, or you will start soon?
The cost of the device for an individual is 2,800
rupees.
Yes, exactly.
Oh, look like cheap.
Yes, well, I think it is, but so that's that should make a good start. That's for the individual. It can be ordered through the internet or through the website, or I mean, there are different ways. So it's available, the product, since a few years already in Europe. We have sold around 100,000 pieces. So the system is operating and the product is on the market. Apart from Europe, Australia and New Zealand also bringing the product to the market. So we launched it officially on the 14th of December during the ITT Tech Fest in Mumbai. And on the 16th of November, during the Nirbhaya Chetna Divas in New Delhi. So what I'm saying as well is that we signed a contract with the Nirbhaya Jyoti Trust, and so for all the sales we do, 10% goes to the trust to make sure that the women who are victimized will get the support of the Nirbhaya Trust whenever needed or whenever required. So that's part of the social structure as well we're taking care of. So from here, after December, right now I'm with a company in Mumbai. We're putting up an advertisement campaign because we need to inform the clients as well, of course, that the product is existing.
Definitely.
And with a big manufacturer in Mumbai, we start cross-selling the product together with a mobile phone, etc. So there are different ways of marketing to other companies who bring it to the market through advertisement campaigns. And then thirdly, we will work with NGOs. And in Pune, I just signed a contract with a local NGO, and they're going to put up a project creating awareness on gender issues among the ladies in the universities and within the big companies, in which people are trained on self-defense, but they're also going to be trained on the usage of the safelet, the usage of the app and the safety device. So this will be part of a social project that the bracelet is installed and brought to the people, and the people are trained on it. So these are different strategies. And the third one is after the companies and the NGOs, it will be the through the government. So soon I will start talks to actually Madhya Pradesh and Haryana governments to see what the government is willing to support on the social level. And
you will have a discussion with state government officials?
Yes.
When you will have a discussion with MP government state official?
The date is not set. So there's somebody I know who's going to make the arrangement. So the date is not set.
Right.
Yeah. And last but not least, the Dutch embassy is fully supporting the cause. I'm from the Netherlands. I say Dutch, but it's a Netherlands embassy. So they're fully supporting the cause. They're giving in information on NGOs and universities and wherever. And together we will make this thing happen, because it needs to be taken care of. When you talk about empowerment, you have to create safety first, because actually, as a human being, we have to create safety and accountability, because that creates empowerment, and that's the philosophy behind it. And when the women are set safe in a domestic situation and in community situations, then any other project will bring, it will be amplified. So that's the whole. That's where I look at it, as a human being,
definitely, yeah.
And as an international developer. Mm-hmm. And so we have to set the women safe within the community, within their houses, and then any other activity will just amplify and have a greater impact.
Yeah. I think your project look like social cause, on the basis of social cause, and you are contacting to many social entrepreneur, mm-hmm. social enterprise, NGOs, not-for-profit organizations. So you are getting positive response in India. What type of response you are getting for last 6 months in India?
Everybody I talk to will say this is very much needed. So that's the basic response. Everybody is aware that there is a problem.
Yeah, women's safety is the big issue in India.
It's a big, big issue.
Yeah.
So people are very much happy about it. And like you reacted, I think 6 or 7, 8 of 10 cases, people will say it's very cheap product. Now and then people say you have to adjust it to the market, and well, there might be some own interest, of course, of the people who say it, but anyway.
A little bit expensive.
Yeah, that's what they say. No, but it's that's a good ride. But I think the price is reasonable, and still, if necessary, we will adapt it, of course. So people are very positive about it, and they think it's a very strong product. And I spoke like the Me Too activist number one in India, and she's very eager about it, and very enthusiastic about the product as well. Just to give an example, but everybody responds in the same way, basically, on the intention and on the potential of the product. So I'm very happy about it. I have a lot of confidence that this is going to work. This. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
As previously you mentioned that you sold more than 1,000 devices around the world.
100,000.
Yeah, around the world. So how you sold? Did you use Amazon.com or any e-commerce site? And it is available on...
Yeah, it is available on Amazon.com right now. Yeah, it is available. And secondly, I will start the collaboration with the person who is taking care of all the Amazon.com deliveries in India. So I'm going to, we'll start the collaboration there at that level. So the distribution network is there as well.
Yeah, definitely.
I have to put things in place, but everything is within the reach of my hands. So we have to do it, yes. It's a social cause. Man and he, you have to stop it. It's a social cause. At the same time, what I'm aiming at is that we have to create an income. We have to create a lot of business, because from the business, and that's why we're targeting first on the middle class and higher classes in the urban areas, because they have to finance. Once the product starts selling, the price can go down and we can bring the product to the lower classes or the rural areas, for instance. So that is the strategy we're using.
I think you should try for subsidy as well, like government buy this device.
Yes.
And government will distribute to humans.
Yeah.
On the basis of subsidy.
Yeah.
So it will be cheaper.
Mm-hmm.
With the help of government.
Yeah.
And in India we have a subsidy system.
Yeah.
Yeah. So many things in India distributing are going on the basis of subsidy.
Yeah.
So you can put a subsidy idea as well.
Yeah.
To government authority.
Well, that's a very good advice. Thank you so much. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we will discuss that then with the Madhya Pradesh government.
Government authority, yeah.
Yeah,
you can
second.
Use this.
Yeah. Okay, very good.
Yeah. And how long your project will be, like how long you will stay more in India for executing this project?
I'm not planning to leave, although I'm leaving in a few weeks for a short period again to the Netherlands, but my business visa is still 4.5 years to go, so I'm not planning to leave. I want to bring this product to the Indian market, and I will stay in India. And I
for a long time.
Yeah. I don't want to leave again.
All right.
I came 32 years ago for the first time to India.
Mm-hmm.
I stayed away for 28 years, but now I'm planning to stay. Yeah, I really want to bring it to the market.
It's very nice.
It's a big market. There's a lot of work to do. There's a big social cause, so you can't do the whole world. So let me try in India. I would love to stay here. I like to be.
Yeah. So Mr. Gerard, who is from Netherlands, came to India on 6 months ago, and he bring very unique project, safety device for every woman. And currently India is facing woman empowerment and woman safety issue. And woman safety has become one of the crucial issue. I think his innovative idea, which is providing three-layer safety to women, definitely will give attention to government as well. Many thanks for coming to our studio. I hope your project will give positive outcome. Thank you very much.
Subscribe our channel and press the bell icon for more updates.